Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing us. In today's video guys, we're going to go ahead and work on the BMW here. 3 series, generation 2005 to 2013. So, we're going to go ahead and show you how to remove and replace rear window regulator. If your window doesn't work, regulator needs to be replaced. We'll show you how to do that. Not very complicated procedure, but a few things you need to know. And also we'll have a video how to initialize the new regulator. Thank you guys for watching. Just a quick reminder, we'll have more than 200 videos on this car. Anything from mechanical, bodywork, anything you can think of. So, if you need help with anything, drop a comment below. We'll try to make a video for you. So, let's go ahead, start running now. All the parts and tools that we use, guys, will be listed in the description of the video below. So check it out, it's for your convenience, and we can proceed now. So we will get a panel removal tool now. Plastic panel removal tool, and we need to remove that trim piece here. I think the last clip will slide towards the back, but we need to confirm that. No, it has only three clips, and one towards the front. One of the clips came out, so we'll show you what you need to do in that case. Okay, you need to just pull it out. Maybe need to get some pliers now and install it where it came out of. Okay, this one right there. So later you can install your trim piece. So now we have to remove that cover because there is hidden bolts underneath. And you start on the bottom side here so you don't damage it. Okay, a few clips holding it and we can pull that one as well. We'll need Torx 20, start looking big. You can find out in the description of the video where we got ours from. We need to remove one screw there. Pretty long screw. Then we have one right there. The same kind of screw like the first one. We have one over here. Okay, this one is out. Let's see if we have anything else. That should be all now. Now with the panel removal tool, bigger panel removal tool. We like the plastic ones because they don't scratch the paint and the panels, but you still have to be careful. Okay, we're going to get it in and there is a few clips holding the panel. Once we remove it, we'll show you where they're located. Towards the end, okay. We'll need to lift it up here, but it still has a few clips holding here, so you need to come out at first and then lift it up. Now we have to disconnect all the cables and wires. This is the door handle and how you disconnect this one. There is one tooth on the back side here. Okay, you need to just pry it with a plastic removal tool. And careful not to break it, and it will come straight out. Later we'll show you how to install it. Okay, now we have the speaker wires here. Pull those one out. And we have a holder, clip holder, and we have the switch here for the window that we need to go ahead and disconnect as well. Okay, let me see how this one is. And here, all you have to do is a flathead screwdriver, a little bitty one. There is one clip that you need to pry open. Okay, and the panel came out of the way now. So, all the clips on the door panels, okay, you can see where they are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 there, 7, 8. And after that, you have all these clips on top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 clips on top. That's where all the clips are located. So next we need to remove that insulation. You can just get a knife and start removing it. You have to be careful not to break it. Later, let me show you that glue actually. When you press it in, it gets stuck again. So that's fine. You can actually even use a new glue if you want to, but you don't have to. You have to press it in really good, and in warm weather, it's going to seal back in. Okay guys, and we have a brand new channel called Electrical Car Repair Life. We have more live videos, diagnostics, engine codes, things like that, so check it out. Please subscribe if you don't mind. Okay, we just have very little left on the very bottom. I'll recommend removing the whole thing so you don't have to worry about breaking it when you're working on the interior components of the door. Okay, just like that. Now, when you put it on the floor or somewhere, do not put it with that side facing down, because if you get dust, it's not going to reseal. So next we need to bring the window down. How you do that? You can start the car even with the door panel off. Okay, you can use your front controls, the master window switch, to bring it down, and we'll show you where you need to stop now. Okay, we need to go a little bit more up. Okay, right there. If you come on this side, okay, you're going to be able to see the clip right here. This is the clip for the window. Now right here, you can see in that hole, the window hole, there is one clip that we need to push down with a plastic tool, and careful not to break if you push too much. Okay, you need to push it in until it releases the window, and you can push the window up by hand. Okay, ours is almost there, but not all the way. Okay, we almost got it. And it locked in place again. So we'll keep doing that. Okay, the clip got loose. And it looks like the window, okay, you can grab the clip on the back side with your finger, but it looks like the window is still a little bit stuck. And once it comes out, you can actually pull it on the back side with your hand, and you need to pull the window up all the way. Now you have two options, one person holding the window so it doesn't drop, or you can go ahead and tape it so it doesn't drop as well. It's your choice how you do that, but if it drops too fast, it can break or hurt your fingers, hands, if they're in the way as well. With the 10mm socket, there is three nuts that we need to remove. Okay, just like that. Now we can go ahead, disconnect the clip, press down and pull the wires out. You could have done that earlier too, so it's more stable. Next, you need to pull the regulator out. It comes on in one certain way. Okay, just like that. So next we have three bolts, screws that we need to remove in order to separate the window motor from the window regulator. So let's go ahead and do that. This one is with a Torx, okay, Torx 25. Torx 25 start looking big. Okay, like this one here. One, second one now. Okay, this is the third one. You can see both things will separate. Okay, just like that. So this is, guys, the regulator. Now we're going to get a new one and show you how to install it in just a second. So you can find out where we got our new window regulator from. We'll show you in the description of the video below. So now we'll go ahead, put it together, okay? You need to install the motor in exactly the same way that it used to be. Get the three screws tied. Okay, don't forget to do that because one of them is not accessible if you install the window regulator. Okay, just like that. Next, if your window is down, ours we just let it down so we don't have to hold it or tape it. You have to bring it by hand all the way up, and again one person holding, or you need to tape it. Okay, like that. And we can go ahead and install the window regulator with the motor assembly. Now, one of the wires got in the way, so be careful not to damage anything. It goes in an angle like that. Need to get the bottom bolt out and the top one as well. Okay, the bottom one is out. All three bolts are out. We will install the nuts. Get those tight. Don't forget to pour your wire until you hear that click. Now bring the window down and we'll need to push it in the clip. Okay, you're going to hear an audible click after that. You might need to help the clip out a little bit. Okay, perfect. It's stuck in place now. From that point on, all we have to do is install the door panel. Everything else in reverse order that we took apart, and that's how you guys remove or replace rear window regulator. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, give a like, and see you guys next time.